we have to achieve enlightenment. Study and retreat together, corporately. unified, corporately or unified. Study is meditation, meditation is study. Independent from the Shedub Sundel. So, giving explanation, studying words, meanings, and practice, meditation practice to actualize the path to enlightenment. like Grung Thumba explained, while I'm listening, I'm reflecting, I meditate. So without separation, these three things without separation, that I practice. So like that, this is according to Kadamba traditions. So doing, we say, happening all together, there's no separation. So it's a Dong Thumba advice. So here, either unified or cooperatively together. So you see, study as well as meditation retreat. Of course, without learning, without explanation, without learning, there's nothing to meditate. There's nothing to meditate. Except the opposite meditation. Meditation, actualizing delusions, making familiar with the delusions, mind training the delusion, that which did not have beginning. This practice did not have beginning from this practice. This training or this mind becoming familiar with the delusion, transforming into delusion, did not have beginning. This familiarization of mind became familiar with the delusion, is that transforming into delusion, this did not have beginning. So that's why we're still experiencing suffering, samsara. Or the blank mind, meditation, blank mind, or the spaced out, being spaced out, many hours, or the being spaced out. Do you understand being spaced out? Or being freaked out. Anyway, or mental nothingness. That nothing exists. So anyway, so this is a great thing. Due to the organization of some good karma, that we have very qualified teachers here, and here again, this right here, and then also many other centers, we have very qualified teachers. So due to that, we're able to have Australia, many other countries, United States, many countries, we have very qualified teachers to learn the extensive Buddha's, you know, scriptures, to learn depth, clarity, the Lama, additional Lama Tzong Khapa's clearest explanation of Buddha's teachings, path to enlightenment, clearest explanation. So we have karma to meet Lama Tzong Khapa teaching, you know, to study, to have correct, clearest, correct meaning and understand words, meanings, and makes unbelievably easy, so easy to say, you know, to correct practice. And then from that correct realization, without taking much time, without, taking long time, with those hardships, you know, so that so yeah, then also not only we leave it up to, not only we leave it up to intellect, not only we leave it understand Dharma up to intellectual, but you see, we say retreat, we, you know, integrate into Lam Rim, integrate all that into Lam Rim, you know, that Lama Tisha set it up with in a few pages. That is very simple, how to go about enlightenment, how to practice all those words, extensive meaning, philosophy, the words, see, and that would expand and those, all those extensive, you know, the scriptures, Sutra and Tantra. So, and putting into daily life practice, you know, meditation path, Lamrim, into daily life activity. Not only sitting on the cushion, meditation sitting on the cushion, but also during daily life activity. The daily life activity, so you put the essence of the whole 84,000 teaching, the Sutra Tantra, that's the number they're putting into in daily also activities, you know. So making life very profound, very most enjoyable, happiest life, most satisfying and fulfilling, you know, and based on bodhicitta, even that based on bodhicitta, the foundation, you know, doing everything out of bodhicitta, even your mentioning Lam Rim, you know, mind training, the impermanence, death, you know, the gradual part of the lower, capable of being the gradual part of the lower, capable of being in general. So if your mind training that, but it's done out of bodhicitta. So that then, not only that, then, not only the meditation done with bodhicitta, but even the, you know, eating, walking, sitting, sleeping, however, doing job, other activities in daily life, then after bodhicitta. So, yeah, so that's, you know, with the attitude to benefit, with the attitude to free the numberless sentient beings, numberless helpings from all the suffering causes, numberous hungry ghosts from all the suffering causes, numberless animals, free them from all the suffering causes, and numberless human beings, free them from all the suffering causes. So, we can see now how many people say, leave aside other problems, but just how many human beings are suffering, even this world, with all these wars, you know, so many people get killed attacking each other. The bombs and all these things, always you hear, every week, almost every day you hear. Here we have peace, but other parts, other countries, other parts of the world, so much suffering. So even by thinking, you know, how to solve these problems in the world, just even human beings' problems, all this incredible fear, terror, so here, to really help sentient beings, you know, even the human beings in this world, to have peace and happiness, you know, especially to have ultimate happiness, and then we need to liberate them from cause of suffering, the delusion, karma. We need to have all the skills to do that. We need to ourselves, we need to realization on the path, which we're going to cause them to actualize the path. So ourselves, we need to have the realization. So that's how, for this studying and doing, studying Dharma, studying Lama Rinpoche, studying the philosophies, those extensive teachings, doing a retreat, and say, particular, say, trying to exercise the path, what we have learned, what we have studied. So that's really best solution, really. Not only see human beings in this earth to have peace and happiness, to cause them, you see, ultimate happiness, liberation from samsara and full enlightenment, the great liberation. Of course, then all other living beings, the numberless sentient beings. Even with the intellectual understanding, we can benefit so much, but especially if we have realization, we're able to offer very deep benefit, very deep benefit to others. Person who has a realization of impermanence, that who has a realization of that, when that person says some words, has an incredible power to transform others' minds, to cut others' delusions. Somebody who has a bodhicitta realization, say a few words, speak a few words to others. That is incredible blessing, power. You know, able to cut the other's self-cherishing thought. You know, incredible, it carries incredible blessing. like hitting a bomb, you see, all the self-judgment, through tongues from others' mind in bodhicitta. that is our own experience when we hear teachings from, you see, great enlightened being lamas or other meditators who have realization, bodhicitta, you see, when we hear from them. It's our own experience, how it's so beneficial, even few words. It's coming out of the realizations. So similar, more we practice, you see, whatever we say, when we consult, teach others, advise others, very powerful, a lot of blessing. Then our actions totally transformed into virtue, you know, totally into, cause to achieve, and only in the cause to achieve liberation from samsara, or only in the cause to achieve enlightenment for a sentient being, only in the cause that which brings happiness to the numberless sentient beings. Whatever we do, that causes that happiness to numberless sentient beings, temporary and ultimate happiness, enlightenment. Like how Lama Tzong Khapa, the Kiddo Rinpoche prays to Lama Tzong Khapa, even breathing in and out. How Kiddo Rinpoche prays to Lama Tzong Khapa, you know, even Gumbo Chuji, Shaiji, Utsun, Tata Dola, maybe Juchuna, you the saviors, even breathing in and out. Become cause of, you see, happiness to numberless, to all the transmigratory beings. Means all the sentient beings who are transmigrating into one of the six realms, in one of them being under the control of karma and delusion. So you see, become cause of happiness for all those numberless transmigrated beings. So then others, see, no question, see, even breathing, other activities, no question, but even the Lama Tzong Khapa is breathing in and out. So then that means, you see, if one has a bodhicitta realization, then that's what even breathing, leave aside other activities, even just breathing, you know, in daily life, breathing in and each breath being, see, cause of happiness for all the suffering sentient beings. So, to study meditation, then if we say, by doing it together, then we actualize, gradually our mind get familiar, see, closer and closer, then you have actual realization. So, from Shimbata was simply, so like the, not the actual switch, but the like cover switch. So that's the effortful bodhicitta, then that leads to effortless actual realization bodhicitta. So that, so in this way, from life to life, there's a mental condition, there's a mental continuity. So life to life, so you see, there's a continuity of good heart. So, so far, from life to life, we have been harming to others with a self-cherishing thought. From life to life, from beginning this rebirth, life to life, you see, harming other sentient beings. So now, if we study and meditate together, you see, to retreat and find bodhicitta, or from life to life, there's a continued good heart, you know, bodhicitta. So we bring So two numberless sentient beings were able to benefit in each life, deeper and deeper, even that deeper and deeper as we realize the, you know, the higher path. So like that. And it is good, and it is a great blessing, and it is a great blessing, you know, by having bodhicitta realization, it's a great blessing in this world, see, in the country, in the area, you see, like Lama Tzong Khapa, the institute here, it is great blessing, you know, for the land, for the people. So that, one time, when His Holiness the Lama was giving teaching Mongol to Tibetan monastery, I don't know which part on the show. I think the Sanas was granting the Lamrim combined with the 8,000 stanza Yedongba, you know, together. And they said, I think there's one great Lama, Gajin Yeltsin, and there's one text, you know, that is explained, kind of combined together. I think, however, Sanas was giving these teachings, combined those two. So that it was explained. there are many dogs at the monastery. There are many dogs at the monastery. So I thought having many dogs is only Tibetan monastery. But actually, when I went to Thailand, I saw in Thailand the monastery is also many dogs. it's not only Tibetan monastery. Anyway, was there Thailand? The monks go for alms in the very early morning. In the very early morning, I think one time, maybe I was with the Lama. I think the Lama. So we had just transit, you know, stayed in the hotel. Then next morning at 6 o'clock, we had to go to we were going to the airport. So 6 o'clock in the morning. The monks were already in the street for to receive alms. So I thought if I was living here, you know, I wouldn't be able to do that. Just got out and go in the street for alms and to receive alms. I thought I wouldn't be able to do that. But the people so devoted, when they see monk, you know, they treat like Buddha. They respect like seeing, they respect like meeting Buddha, you know, they're so devoted. So in the early morning, the women's from family, they carry the tray, you know, filled with food. They kneel down. Not in the car road, but above the platform. Kneel down and they kneel down. They carry the tray with food. You see, that they carry. So then, monk they pass where, you know, whoever again comes there, receives the food. So yeah. So what you are supposed to eat, you are supposed to accept any food. I think there's no question of veg or non-veg. I think no selections. One to have steak or one to have this and that. So you just have to accept whatever is offered. So Keshe Tengi, you know, Baso Yogini. So he was in Thailand for many years, Atapaksa. He was Thailand for many years. So Geshe-la said that there was in the food there was something very delicious, something very very delicious. I think he had for many years, but one day he realized that it was a lobster, I think. So lobster's the meat, you know, lobster's the meat inside. So this one put backside. Meat, I think this is bone, I'm not sure. Shell, yeah. So the inside meat is taken out and put on top. So that's how they served. And of course, they cooked, you know. So Geshe-la enjoyed very much for many years, but didn't realize what it was. So one day he realized it was the lobster? Yeah, lobster, yeah, lobster. Lobster or frog? Some frog? Does it frog? Does it bone? Oh, I see. Maybe lobster. Maybe lobster. Huh? Maybe crabs. So one day he discovered, oh, this is a crab. So now the label changed. So. So I was going to say. Yeah? Oh, yes. So that's thank you very much. I lost. So that time someone said, you know, someone talked about dogs. Someone said, only, you know, but the monks would give him food to the dogs. So Thailand, you see, the monks come back from arm, the leftover food they give the dogs. That's how that I think monastery have many dogs in Thailand. So anyway, but that might be difficult to digest for the dogs because this is an offering. This offering offered with the devotion by people, so the Sangha's food. And they get to sit, made the dogs get many disease. I know, I remember from Baksa, where I lived 8 years, they get so much mean, as a, oh, the hairs worn out, you know, hairs go fall out, and there's so many infections, so many. So maybe they don't digest because the pollution, the Sangha's food is offered by others with devotion, so they cannot practice Dharma. So I think maybe it doesn't, it's a pollution, it's different, difficult to say. That's just how to say. So the dog, many dogs get sick, you know, like that. So then the son said that only those, and because giving food to the dogs, his son said that the dogs get benefits. Only somebody has bodhicitta, then giving even say, a handful of food to a dog, then the only thing they get benefit. I think benefit means to the mind, the dog. It's not talking about, you see, stop hunger. It's not talking benefit to the mind of the dog, you see. Just like that. So, so ourselves, in the essence of what I'm saying, ourselves, we stop giving harm with the body, we stop giving harm others with speech, and gradually we stop giving harm also with even just, you know, delusion arising. You see, even negative motivation, you see, giving harm others, so that we gradually, we, how to say, able to stop all the harms to other human beings. And the absence of that is that peace, happiness, what they're receiving. So even, you know, even while we are practicing, you see, mantling in the renunciation, right view, bodhicitta, and living the vows, there, living the lay vows, morality, into the lay vows. So that many harm we stop. We stop that many harm to other sentient beings. So that's giving peace and happiness to sentient beings. And that includes all the human beings, animals, in this, you know, what we can see in this world. So already we're benefiting to sentient beings like this. Like this, then the trouble. Then of course there's tantric practice source like that. benefiting so much, unbelievable. You see, then we dedicated merits. we collect extensive merits with bodhicitta. Let me discuss merit every time when we change the motivation bodhicitta. And when we meditate on bodhicitta, you know, those techniques. And when each time when we meditate on the emptiness, we collect unconceivable merit, like another one, unbelievable. So, and say, listening, teaching, you know, studying, you see, all those merits we collect, we dedicate at end to all sentient beings. So that includes all the human beings, animals who are in this world, those who are much suffering, those people who are so much suffering in the Iraq, or those Palestinians, or say, Israel, or whatever, so forth. Many parts of the world where there's so much suffering, so they all get the, and when we dedicate marriage, they all receive this. So, say, similarly, we, you know, when somebody died, we do puja. We chant those powerful mantras, purifying, very powerful, purifying mantras. And it helps them, liberates them from the heaviest sufferings in the hell realm, hungry animals. We dedicate our merits to them, it helps them, you know. We make statues to benefit for, dedicate merits to them, and they get higher birth. By reading teachings on present paramita, instead of doing meditation on emptiness, we dedicate merits to them, see. So it's very common that it helps them. So same thing, it helps all those who are people, you know, in the war, who died, you know, all those. So we dedicate merits to, you know, but after we've done the practice, so there's so much benefit to what we do, what we offer, if we dare to a sentient being. So that you see, once the karma is ripened, it's not easy. Before the karma is ripened, easier to manage. But once the karma is ripened, not easy. There are numberless Buddhas and Bodhisattvas whose holy mind only whom they cherish is only sentient beings, whom they work for only sentient beings. No one else. You see, only sentient beings. But you see, that's it. If it does not depend on sentient beings' karma, if it does not depend on from sentient beings' side purifying their negative karma, clean good karma, the cause of happiness, hard birth, liberation from samsara, enlightenment, so forth, even the temporary happiness. If it's totally up to if it's totally up to Buddhasappas, or even in Christian terms, can be said, if it's only, or Muslim terms, if it's only up to the God, see, you know, reason can be similar. So anyway, if the God has compassion to all living beings, if the God is like sky, you know, nothing, something like that, then you know, there's no talk about compassion, having compassion. But however, compassion and all the power, God has all the power, you know, and full understanding. So as Buddhists say, Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, especially Buddhas, they have compassion to every single suffering beings. Not only that, or omniscient mind, not only that, perfect power, to save the sentient beings from the sufferings. So if it's only up to, if it doesn't depend on sentient beings' karma, if it's only up to Buddha, God, but God in the sense having compassion for all living beings, having perfect power, omniscient mind, like that. However, there wouldn't be one sentient being left. There wouldn't be one suffering sentient being, you see, left out. See, there wouldn't be one. By now, there wouldn't be even one suffering sentient being left out. You see, I think whenever Buddha came in existence, there wouldn't be anything being left out. You see, everyone would have enlightened without delay, even a second. So it's only in the hand of Buddha or only in the hand of God. So, therefore, sentient beings' sight need to put, therefore, say, need to put effort. For example, a person who is sick, you know, or deformed, or sick in whole life, for example, there's one example, you see, without mentioning the Lord realm sufferings. So like that, whatever treatment is done, nothing helps, and difficult to cure, like that, you see. Even there's a method in the world exists to cure, either through meditation, healing, or medicines, even it exists in the world, but somehow that person doesn't encounter that method. Some other person is sick. And some other person, you see, encounter those methods and some miracles happens, is recovered. You see, even it is incurable disease, regarded by common people as incurable, but you see, like that. So we need to achieve, so there, as long as do not change the karma, as long as we don't change the karma, we don't do something with the karma, the cause of the suffering, then you have to experience the result of suffering, no matter how many lifetimes it lasts, how many eons it lasts. So that is here. So if you're able to change the cause, able to do something with the cause, then they change in there, then you don't need experience at all, or just a very short time, say just in this life, or even that very short, you know, finish by experiencing even nightmare or the dream, some frightening dream, or some say headache, or some stomach ache, or some people criticizing. Some people criticizing you, finish that karma, then having the karma, you know, finish experiencing, you see. Which manifests into something other people criticizing, putting you down, see, that and finished. Or you feel some depression, you know. The many years of suffering in the lower realms, or many lifetimes, manifest into depression, dislike, depression, and you know, unhappy mind. Or a few months, or some days, some weeks, however, finished by that. Manifest, however, you know, something has to experience, so manifest into that, you see. And then finish all that heavy karma, you see, that very heavy karma. So that. So anyway, by doing something in the cause, see, purifying, see, then not committing again, see, like that. So the I was mentioning that I met the two who works for Tibetan campaign in Washington, Rinpoche, and the other person. So met in Holland. So I was just expressing that. Along with whatever political method, but along with that, some dharma, you know, together, we see behind dharma force, so then we can succeed. But the dharma, the political method, that's the method, however, that's a condition, but the main cause of, say, independence, or main cause of the freedom of Tibet, the main cause, since that is happiness, so the result has to be virtue. The karma has to be good karma, you see. Through negative karma, you can't achieve that happiness. So, so it needs to the karma, cause of that happiness, independence or freedom, the Tibetan people say. So that lay, or the action that has to be part, good karma. So by changing karma, by making that good karma powerful, only then you can have, you can have success of the result, happiness, the freedom, you see, and that. So even in that case, same, see, you're dealing with karma, even in case of Tibetan freedom, independence, it's a question of karma. It's a question of karma. Everything depends on karma. So it's a question of karma, question of changing karma, making the cause powerful, you know, the good karma, see. By the Tibetan people, by the community, see, have to make that karma very powerful. So his holiness is, you know, generosity, compassion, Buddha, can guide, help, but from the people, their side, they need the lay or the karma. Since that result it means happiness, so the good karma that has met from their side powerful. So then I'm just using that as an example. I guess, for example, 500 feet material statue. By building this, so many sentient beings get benefit. So I guess one reason for the sentient beings to get the benefit, to get this incredible, extensive benefit from this statue, to exercise this, the sentient beings also need merit, you know. They need merit in order to exercise such this statue, and to get incredible benefit. Such easy way to appear on the karma, quite merit. Anyone from all over the world who get benefit, that is so much benefit. So, able to achieve enlightenment, kukha, or to achieve realization, kukha, so all those benefits, they have to, from their side, they have to have, a karma, you know, like that. to be able to enter such a statue, what else in the world? So it's a, that's of course one explanation. One explanation. Besides, organizers need a lot of merit to that. So I'm just using this as an example. Even in the individual case, whatever project you are aiming, whatever success you are aiming, if it's a happiness, then it's all to do with the lay action. You see, need to, whatever skill smart you are, even business, you know, whatever smart you are, that alone is not, doesn't mean you will succeed. You need a merit behind, like a fund for project, like a big project. So you need a lot of merit, for the success of that, you see. So just being smart, being good political or politician or good, you are smart in ideas that alone is not the answer. That just can be conditioned. Even you succeed, but that can be just condition for success. So that. So here. So, our learning Dharma, practicing, and see, trying to stop non-virtuous actions, and everyday life engage virtuous actions, then try to maintain by maintaining the path to every realization. So, this really is the best way to benefit of sentient beings. with this, we can give ultimate benefit. We can get can purify the negative karma, cause which they already created, by educating them Dharma, can purify the negative karma, and then they stop creating again negative karma. And this way, they can achieve happiness, life after life. You see, they can achieve happiness and meet Dharma, practice Dharma, and develop the mind more and more. It's the path. However, sensual things that. So, without talking the complete Mahayana path or the sutra and the learning of the tantric path, just less real path, you see, by educating them for noble truth, educating them through suffering, true cause of suffering, making them aware there's a cessation of suffering you can achieve, and then how it's possible is because there's true path that you can see. There are many qualified teachers that they can learn and practice and actualize the path. So make it impossible. However, sooner or later, make it reach to the end of the suffering. However, impossible to experience suffering again by completely ceasing even the seed of delusion. You see? So we are able to, that we can educate the sentient beings, you see. Just even educate them by teaching for noble truth, that's unbelievable. It causes them to achieve ultimate benefit, you see, happiness. So just that itself is unbelievable. So without talking about enlightenment, great liberation, the non-abiding soul state, all those very high without talking about, just this benefit we can offer, more will and Dharma practice. So this is unbelievable. So many sentient beings, human beings in this world that we can benefit, you see. So therefore, we must rejoice, and we are unbelievable. Therefore, we are unbelievable fortunate, incredible fortunate. That we are liberating ourselves every day during practice, learning Dharma, and we can cause this. That we have incredible opportunity to liberate others. So this is the best solution, the ultimate solution. This is the best answer for the world peace, and this is our contribution for the world peace, So we must realize it, we must recognize this, so I think that's all. That's all today, okay? Thank you so much. Thank you very much, okay? Yeah. Okay.